for as long as can be remembered. Storks delivered babies. From their perch on Stork Mountain, it was an honor and a privilege to serve. It was our duty, our core belief, the driving force of our very lifeblood. It wasn't always easy. This was our challenge. This was our sacred duty. No matter how tough or impossible or brutal or harsh or inhumane or savage, we would triumph over adversity. Goodness, we don't do that anymore.
There! Right there!
The problem was, we had the wrong cargo.
Our new phones!
Luckily now, Storks deliver packages for cornerstore.com.
Yo, Kev Rod, looking good, my man!
Oh, I love this guy.
Perfect landing, chicken check. What? Millionth package? Not possible. I thought I was only at 20.
Hey, Junior, are you gonna celebrate?
You know what? You're right. I should celebrate. What are you guys doing this weekend? Are you guys free?
The wife and I are celebrating another anniversary.
Got my kids' game this weekend.
Family reunion. The whole family's coming.
Oh, just wanted to confirm that you were all busy. I assumed you were all busy and you are, so if anything changes, let me know. I maybe could get out of work. Probably can't, but let me know if you can.
Great job out there, brah.
Thanks, Pigeon Toady.
Check out my girlfriend. She's in Canada.
Yeah, huh?
She migrated. She's not made up.
Okay.
Look at her. Look at her. She exists, brah.
That's great.
Hey, did you guys hear about Roger?
Ha! Oh, my goodness. Are you okay?
Well, hey, brah. Oh, sorry. What? Okay. I tell you about my girlfriend.
Hey, boss wants to see you.
Hunter wants to see me? All right, head in the game, Junior. So you're Hunter. What do you do around here? No, I hate that. Hunter, nice to meet you. No, that's too robot. Just say it normal. Just say it normal. Here we go. Nice to meet you. What is wrong with me?
Junior. Hunter. You know why I built my office entirely out of glass, even though birds can't see glass?
I do not.
Power move. 18 years ago, I saved all storks by getting out of babies and into package delivery. Now, this Monday at StorkCon, the board will announce they're kicking me upstairs. I'm going to be named chairman, which means you are going to be named Buzz.
Cool, 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 cool. Very cool, very cool.
Now, look upon your domain with your eyes wide open.
Yeah, wider.
I love it. Feels good.
How can you be boss if you can't look at it?
If I go blind, it was worth it.
You know the hardest thing about being boss?
Staring at the sun?
No, this is easy.
Whether to be like a friend boss or a distant weird boss?
Always be distant and weird. What's the matter with you?
Sorry.
No, it's dealing with that.
The orphan Tulip? I don't understand.
Do you know why we stopped delivering babies?
Because there are so many other ways of getting babies?
Yes. But that's not the whole story. 18 years ago, when we still delivered human infants, a stork named Jasper went crazy and tried to keep a baby. Tulip's beacon broke,
Whoops.
Her address was destroyed, so we could no longer deliver her.
My baby.
It was then I realized that there was no future in baby delivery. Now, the orphan Tulip has just turned 18, which means we can finally liberate her and return her to the human world.
But she's no trouble.
Oh, she isn't, is she? Here's our profit chart.
Oh, I love a good profit chart.
Oh, me too. Oh.
Yeah.
The peaks are when Tulip is on vacation, asleep, or out with the flu. The valleys are when she tries to help.
Cool. I will liberate her. Consider her liberated. And if she doesn't want to be liberated?
Fire her. I'm talking about firing her.
Really?
The only thing you need to do to be named boss on Monday is liberate the orphan Tulip. If I'm not being clear, I mean fire her.
Yes, sir. I am on it. I've read between the lines and heard you overtly. Excuse me, Orphan Tulip?
Junior? You're talking to me?
Yes, Orphan Tulip?
No, it's just that you never talk to
me. Well, yeah, that's changing starting today, Orphan Tulip.
Oh, Tulip is just fine. Orphan hurts my heart. I have so many questions to ask you.
Why don't you come down and we can talk all day?
Okay, I will be down, as will my friends. We are going to fly right down.
What? No, that's a quail, an emu, there's a chicken, they cannot fly.
Yeah, until now.
She's helping us achieve our dreams.
That's right, Douglas.
You know it.
It is still a personal victory if you use the bucket.
Okay, we'll all not use the bucket.
Wait, what?
Ha ha, Tulip doesn't fit in. We're all the same and she's a weirdo.
Whoa, that's not nice. She's
had a hard life.
Okay.
This is gonna be great, guys. Countdown. A 3, 2, 1.
Oh.
It's working. We're flying. Whoa.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Enough of this. I want to go fast.
No, Douglas, what? No.
This is the greatest day of my life. I'm flying. This is my moment!
Douglas, no! Bye, Douglas, no!
How can my dreams go so horribly wrong?
Gotcha! I'm fouling.
No!
Oh, that's not so bad.
I got it!
I'm sorry. Oh, I'm so sorry. I don't fit in anywhere, and all I want to do is help.
Oh boy. Tulip. Okay, I have news for you.
Before you finish, for you to come to wish me happy birthday, that's just the nicest, you know? It's like a little rainbow. So, thank you. That's really nice. But, oh, I'm sorry. Nah, I interrupted you. What were you going to tell me?
Oh boy. I have wonderful news for you. You have been liberated.
What does that mean?
Well, it means that you are...
What?
You're...
Are you okay?
Excuse me. You're fantastic.
Really? Because I just blew up most of the factory.
Oh, yeah. What a twist. Well, it means... I'm putting you in charge of your very own department. You are the new head of letter sorting!
I didn't even know we still got letters!